Hi guys, today I will tell you the three lessons that I have received from the Australian billionaire Jack Cohen. See you in the next part. Hi and welcome from Sydney, Australia. I am in the residential area of Point Piper. This is the most expensive residential area in the entire southern hemisphere. I'm standing in front of the house of Mr. Jack Cohen. Jack is a Canadian-born Australian billionaire. He came to Australia with a business idea to sell fast food in Australia. And he bought the Burger King franchise and developed it under his name Hungry Jack. He also owns the franchise of KFC in Australia and is major shareholder in Domino's Pizza. With these three investments, these three companies and many other companies, he became one of the most successful and the wealthiest entrepreneurs in Australia. You will meet today to talk about his success secrets, to talk about his life story and what made him so extremely successful. As you can see, I'm very excited about this interview and we'll talk later. I will tell you later after the interview what he told me. And of course, the details I will write about in my upcoming book. Jack Cohen is the guy who brought fast food to Australia. First he built the KFC franchise there, then he built the Burger King in Australia. And you may wonder, when you are from Australia or you have been to Australia, that the Burger King in Australia is called actually Hungry Jack's, and this is the only country in the world that Burger King is not called Burger King, but it's called by the name of its creator, Hungry Jack's, after Jack Cohen's name. And of course, Burger King was trying to get Jack to name it differently, to name it Burger King after a while, after he became so successful, but they didn't manage and they were trying to go into court with that and to sue him and so on and so on. A long story, but he prevailed. So when you go to Australia and you see, it looks the same. I mean, the look and feel is the same as Burger King, but it just has a different name, Hungry Jack's. And then he also built the Australian Domino's Pizza, which is active in over 10 countries right now. And they are actually bigger than the mother company, than the American Domino's Pizza. And today I will tell you three lessons that he gave me when I visited him in Melbourne and we spent a day in his house talking about what made him so extremely successful in business. He has shares in Competitive Foods Australia. His company is called Competitive Foods Australia, and Competitive Foods Australia owns roughly 3,000 restaurants right now. And most of it is in Domino's Pizza, but also, as I said, Burger King Australia. So, the three lessons. The first lesson that he gave me is, don't get a job, go into business instead. This is something that he realized when he was at the university, or after the university. This was an advice that his mentor gave him. After graduating from the university, he was looking for a job. And he had a friend, an experienced entrepreneur, Bill Pollock, who had a company in temporary services, was an experienced entrepreneur, and Jack went to him to maybe to apply for a job. And Bill told him he was prepared to give him a job, but he advised him if he really wants to be successful, he should go into business himself. But Jack didn't really realize the value of that advice at the moment and started to work for a big insurance company in Canada. And he was always good in sales. So he was making quite a good money, but a friend of him owned two stores in a fast food franchise. I'm not sure if it was KFC or Burger King or McDonald's, one of them. And the friend of him made less money a year than he did. And as Jack was making, and he was making really good money in that insurance company. He was one of the most successful salespeople in that insurance company, and it was considered a lot of money. But this friend of him, after 2 years of building a business, he sold the two stores for an amount 10 times as much as Jack. So he realized Jack wasn't really building value for himself. He wasn't building something that is saleable. And he realized the difference between making money and building value. So he went again to Bill Pollock, and Bill Pollock became a mentor of him and also an investor in his company that he built. And he emigrated actually from Canada, because he was a Canadian, went to Australia to build this KFC franchise. And Jack told me to avoid the so-called golden cage. So it's really a danger for your future, for your future success, if you have a really good paid job. And when you start building up your expenses, like taking a mortgage maybe, or having a luxurious life, being in a golf club, or maybe sending your children to private school, if you have this monthly expenses, this and a good job that allows you to afford these expenses, this is really in danger, because you become a prisoner of that job. And he told me about a speech he gave to an MBA class. And in that speech, he told the students that they are really in a disadvantage in comparison to him, because at his times, when he graduated, he could get a job for $6,000 maybe, but they are going to be offered $150,000 a year, and it is really difficult for them to reject such offer. And they will build a lifestyle, they will become a member of a golf club, they will take a mortgage, buy a huge house, they will maybe send their children to private school, and they will become a prisoner of the lifestyle. So it will be really difficult to give up this job and to go into business with all these risks, with the risk of losing everything, and of course not making money, maybe having to live without money for several years, maybe for decades, and not being able to afford all that luxury. And he said, when I made the decision I was going to go into business, I had everything to gain and not much to lose. So this is really a disadvantage, the so-called golden cage that you easily can get into, and this may be detrimental to your future and to you becoming an entrepreneur, and then of course a successful entrepreneur. And he said, most satisfied people I know have control over their own lives and affairs. We are probably all seeking the independence to do what we want to, when and where we want to do it. How many unhappy people are there? 90% of the population are in jobs, activities or relationships out of economic necessity. They stay in a job they hate because they have got a mortgage, got school payments, and they become prisoners. So how do you control it? How do you maintain the ability to control that? And I explain to you how you do it. You just avoid this golden cage, you go into business and you build your own company that creates value, and that is the source of your life, of you maintaining your lifestyle and not being dependent on the paycheck somebody else is paying you. This was the first lesson I want to share with you that I got from Jack Cohen. The other lesson is one of the billionaire skills, and this is relationships and understanding people. Jack Cohen is probably one of the most generous people I know, the most networked and connected people in the world. He was the global president of YPO, Young Presidents Organization. This is an organization for people below 40 who are CEOs or owners of big companies. And he was not only a member of that, he was the global president, so the top one person in that organization. I asked Jack, what is the most important thing in business? And he told me, relationships for me are what's all about it. Business is about people and relationships. How do you get them to cooperate? Do it together rather than against each other. So to me, if there is one thing that's important, that's it, relationships. And you have to realize you can't build a big, great organization without people. You can't do it alone. There are always people, either they are your employees or your business partners or your customers, your investors, the society. And if you base the development of your company on relationships, then it's just much more sustainable. And to build relationships, you have to understand people, how they think, what motivates them, what drives them, and how to cooperate with them to the advantage of all participants, of all people involved. And I asked Jack what determined his success. His answer won't surprise you. He said, probably the ability to understand people, what they want, how to enable them to achieve their goals, while at the same time helping me achieve mine. So again, this win-win strategy that I have been talking about in several videos already, how to cooperate with people in a way that they achieve their goals and you achieve your goals as well. And the third lesson I have learned from Jack is the proactivity. This is something that billionaires are extremely good at. So most people think that life happens to them, that they are product of circumstances. And a billionaire sees himself as the driving force, as the creator of the circumstances and not its victim. So don't wait for things to happen around you. You should take action. You should take the things in your hands and make them happen. And Jack's motto is, don't wait for your ship to come in, row out to meet it. And it really incorporates what Jack and all the self-made billionaires I have interviewed are about taking the fate in your hands, taking your future in your hands, about making things happen, about making things possible, not waiting for anything around you, for the favorable conditions, for something, you know, for the success to fall from the sky upon you, for some lucky strike, whatever. Take your fate in your hands and make it happen. I wonder what are your experiences in your businesses, in your life, with understanding people, with relationships, with going into business and maybe about the golden cage. Are you maybe in a golden cage or maybe in any prisoner relationship where you can't afford to take risks to go into business because you have so many expenses, maybe debt, maybe mortgage that you have to pay off, and you are dependent on the income from a corporation, from a company, from your job. You are dependent on your paycheck and not being able to actually decide freely about your future, about your life, about your fate. What about the proactivity? What about taking action? Of course, I learned much more from Jack Cohen. All of that you will find in my book, The Billion Dollar Secret. I invite you to read it. Share this video with your loved ones, with your friends. They will thank you for that. I talk here about how the best entrepreneurs, how the self-made billionaires of our times think and act. I talk also about money, about cryptocurrencies, about economics, and about doing great and impossible things in your life and business. So if you like that video, you will certainly like my other videos. I invite you to watch them. That's it for today. Give me a thumb up or thumb down if you don't like this video. Subscribe if you haven't. I wish you a fantastic day. Let's do something extraordinary today.